Hey guys.
Well, this is starting out as a fun video. So, as a lot of you know, I am starting the John Muir Trail in 1 week from today. I thought I'd take this opportunity to not only play with my new camera equipment, but also answer a big question that I'm always getting when I'm asked about long distance backpacking. What do you eat? I need to stop looking over there. I need to look at the lens. I love my camera. So I thought I'd share with you over the years from my experience what I think is, at least for me, the most advantageous foods to take. And also my secret little tip on how to avoid taking 60 pounds of food. I'm doing the John Muir in 3 weeks with no resupply. A lot of people call me crazy, and I am, but totally doable, and I'm gonna prove it. I did the Tahoe Yosemite Trail last year, and that was 2 weeks, didn't have a resupply. 1 week more, no problem. Without further ado, here's my food crap. Stop looking at this. I need to look here. Yeah, look at me. Look at me looking at you. Looking at you. Looking at me. Huh? What does this mean? What does this even mean? What does that do? Trippy. For the big meals, of course, dehydrated foods. I prefer Mountain House, and this stuff is great. I actually had to go and get more because I bought this for the trip and I kept eating it. Every morning on the trail, I gotta have my ramen. So typically I have one of these for each morning, a big dinner for each night. And then I just need sugar. I need pure unadulterated sugar. Dates are the best. Pineapple, cherries, blueberries, apricots. Ramen in the morning is, you know, you got protein, fat, and good carbs. At night, after you've been stressing your muscles all day, a big heavy meal, go to bed, and with all this yummy goodness, you'll be rebuilding, repairing with the fats and proteins. During the day, you're like a little coal burning train, just sugar, sugar, sugar. I don't know how many times I've been bonking and I do something like eat nuts and stuff and it does not work. I need sugar. Pecans, walnuts, pistachios. And I mention this all the time. Little things that make you happy. These are yogurt and chocolate covered raisins. Got some paydays. I'm gonna get more than this. These are really great. Honey stinger, little, what are they? 160 calories. Pick-me-ups. One of these saved my butt on a tough climb. Tons of electrolytes. This is Cytomax, but whatever. Gatorade, whatever. I at least try to have one of these a day. Replenish all the electrolytes. As far as vitamins go, I've recently discovered, because of my brother, Ovaltine. This has like tons of good stuff. So I figure I'm gonna put it in my coffee. I have to have coffee. Brooklyn ain't going nowhere without her coffee. I'm gonna have, well, not this. This is ridiculous. Small bottle of olive oil. Because I will be doing some fishing. You know, you can't carry enough food. Especially without a resupply, you can't carry enough food. So I'll be fishing and foraging. I happen to know some delectables out there. Fresh garlic is a must. Ginger, fresh ginger. Delicious. Helps the blood circulation, but also it's an anti-inflammatory. So I try to eat this at night, put a little bit in my dinner, and I like to think it helps with my poor, beat up, swollen legs. And of course, I never go backpacking without Jack. Everyone always thinks I'm alone. And also, on this side, in bold, friendly letters, are the words, don't panic. I mean, obviously, this is not enough food. You wanna know my secret? Which totally worked last year. Get fat. Oh, it's great. I've been munching on crap since the beginning of the year, and I put on a unhealthy, well, healthy, whatever, healthy 15 extra pounds. So, I'll tell you how I did it last year, how I'm doing it this year. Worked out perfectly for me. Okay, so last year I did Tahoe to Yosemite, yay! All on the Pacific Crest Trail. And it was 186 miles and I did it in 15 days. Now, sorry guys, this is where there's math. So I had all my foodstuffs, as much as I could carry. I had those Mountain House dinners. I had energy bars. I had my big pack of ramen. Love ramen. I always have my fresh garlic and ginger. That's ginger. I think that's ginger. All of that food was 26,000 calories, and that 26,000 calories was 20 pounds. So I had a 20-pound pack, add all that food, that was 40 pounds. So I also lost 15 pounds, even with all that food. And 1 pound of human chub is 3,600 calories, which means I burned and lost 54,000 calories. And 54,000 calories burned, plus the 26,000 calories, 20 pounds of food, that I ate, gave me a total of 80,000 calories needed for my 2-week trip. So 15 days and 80,000 calories means I was burning about 5,300 calories a day. So 26,000 calories was 20 pounds of food. How much would 80,000 calories weigh? Yeah, that'd be like 60 pounds. Are you kidding me? That makes a very sad Brooklyn. No, so I gained 10 pounds. I lost 15. But gain weight, start out as little chubby Brooklyn, and work it off, come back as skinny little marmot Brooklyn. Yay! Yeah, so 80,000 calories. I had an excess of 30 pounds, my 20 pounds of food and 10 pounds on my butt, and which is way better than 60 pounds of food. So this was without a resupply. But even if I had a resupply, I would have had to eat all that. But every night, I was happy. I was full, I was content. Here's me leaning on a rock. So, could I possibly have eaten more? Yeah, I don't think with a resupply, I could not have eaten more. Bad things happen when you eat more, just in the woods, But yeah, I can't eat more. So what do? You gain weight. Gain weight, you don't have to carry it. Eat donuts, donuts with sprinkles. Have yourself some beer. Oh yeah, Dos Equis, beer. And there you go, no more math. So yeah, that's what I do. Gain a little bit of weight and then you don't have to carry so much. 20 pounds with a little, 10 pounds of chub instead of 60 pounds of food on my back. You can't carry that much and you can't eat that much. So last year, I gained 10 pounds, lost 15 in 15 days. It's about a pound a day. This is 21 days. So I've gained 15 pounds of chub. I got like boobs and everything. People look at me and they're like, are you working out? I'm like, no. I'm gonna do the John Muir Trail and, donuts, pizza. I've been doing isometric muscular exercises. Keep strong legs, especially since I'm carrying extra weight. Maybe it's just me, but once I get out there and I'm super, super physical, I just burn, and I come back like a starved marmot. So that's my little tips and tricks, the foods that I like. I got one more week. Talk to you soon. I don't know why I wore this shirt. I love my camera, look. I can see myself. Hey, ooh.